Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. Today, I truly have somebody that I have huge respect for. He is a guru in the data integration space. He has been around for a long time. He's none other than Mark Kromer. Mark, do you want to introduce yourself?
Absolutely. Thank you, Swetha. Lovely introduction. So I'm Mark. I'm a product manager for the Data Factory team. I have been with the Data Factory team for almost 9 years now, and I'm really excited to be on this journey with you all. As you know, we've built Data Factory from an Azure-only product into Synapse and now into the SaaS offering known as Microsoft Fabric. So it's been an awesome, exciting journey. And thank you for being a great partner with me on this journey.
Thank you, Mark. So before we get into all the goodness of data integration and what it brings to bear for our customers, can you tell us why Data Factory in Microsoft Fabric matters?
Yeah, it matters a lot because when you're going to build your cloud analytics solution and you're going to do that in Microsoft Fabric, that is our, you know, our SaaS, the best place to build all your data analytics is in Fabric, right? So when you do that, you're going to be bringing in just tons of data, right? You need to process that data. You need to move it into your one lake. You need to transform it. And then you need to run all the processes around it, like your notebooks and your story procedures and all the code that you have within your data team. In fact, sometimes you might even want to build some pipelines that are maybe visually oriented pipelines to say that you want to do step one, step two, step three. Or if you like to write code and you're a Python coder, you might want to use Airflow to orchestrate a lot of that. Another thing you might want to do is you might want to replicate a lot of your existing data as you move into Fabric, so you want to use things like database mirroring. So why Data Factory is because that is the feature within Fabric that has all of that. Mm-hmm. All of that unbelievable goodness around data integration, data transformation, data movement, that is all what Data Factory is, and it's all within a one-stop shop in Fabric. And we have a way to do it very simply and easily. We have UI interfaces for all of that. And we actually happen to have a slide right now that shows you all those things I just said in a much more concise manner. So that's awesome. And one thing that's that actually, you know, kind of like triggered in my mind that I want to make sure that you're all aware of is because this is Fabric, because it's Microsoft, we understand that the way you work with data is in a way that needs to be collaborative. And so you see on the slide, we talk about deployment and observability, being able to see how your processes are running within Data Factory, how your pipelines are running, how your data flows are transforming data, where they are in the stages. All built in, all through CI/CD, so you can collaborate, you can move easily from dev to test to prod. And then we mustn't forget that this is all AI powered, right? So this super improved way to work with Data Factory in Fabric, as opposed to maybe the way you worked with it in, you know, near and dear to my heart is Azure Data Factory, mm-hmm. is that you can express what you want to do, your intent, all through natural language.
Wonderful.
Completely enabled within Fabric. That, Swetha, is the answer to that question.
Wow, that's loaded information.
Oh my God, yes.
So we'll uncover a few of those. So if I try to reiterate what we just heard, is Data Factory is your front door entry into Fabric, if I may say so.
That's right.
Because that's exactly where you ingest data from any which way, either using your pipelines, your copy job, or database mirroring, land the data into one lake or any other destination of your choice for your data needs. But it doesn't stop there. You can also do transformations because if you really think about a medallion architecture, your bronze is where you bring the data, you know, land it somewhere, mm-hmm. and you can use orchestration pipelines. Before we even get there, you can use Dataflow's Gentoo for
right.
your ETL transformations.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And then in order to orchestrate all these, into step one, step two on when to do what to run after a success or a failure. So that can all be orchestrated using pipeline.
That's right.
But I also heard about Airflow. Can you elaborate a little bit about that?
Yeah, and so when you are, I mean, you put it up perfectly, and what happens is as you get your data into one lake and you start to build this unbelievable, you know, analytics solution that you're building for your business, there's a lot of series of things that you want to do with that data that's sitting there in one lake. Now, the easiest way to get started with this is to build those pipelines, like you said. That is a completely, you know, drag and drop interface. It's a point and click interface. It's a UI driven interface. There are API surface areas for that, but it's primarily for code free. Now, If you like to automate a lot of this, if you are really good at Python, a really common way to build these sort of orchestration processes or build what are known as DAGs or direct acyclical graphs, acyclical graphs. And those are DAGs. And to express those within Fabric, we use the open source Apache Airflow application for that. And so that is built into Fabric, and we actually SaaSified, if you will, Apache Airflow, where you don't even need to stand up any infrastructure. You just simply start expressing your DAGs as Python, and then you can execute those against the startup pools that we have that run Airflow for you. So those are the different ways that you can orchestrate those things.
That is amazing. So we are really catering with the no-code, low-code, you know, developer base, as well as the heavy coding experience using Python or any other language using Airflow.
So that's right.
It is really for both no-code, low-code, as well as
code first. We understand that we need to meet you as a user of Fabric and of Microsoft Data where you work, right? And so there are many different ways, many different surface areas for data engineers and data integrators. And so we're absolutely there to abide by that. And I think it also shows that as Microsoft, you know, we also are very accommodating. We also really buy into the open source platforms as well, like Apache Airflow, and bringing that into Fabric.
Wonderful.
In this case,
So Mark, at Fabric Tech Talk Fridays, we always say, enough of all the talking, let's get to the laptop and see what you got in terms of, you know, bringing all these different capabilities and putting it into action. So let's look at the demo.
Okay, so here I am in my data factory in Azure. So this is ADF, Azure Data Factory, and you can see that I have a pipeline with a couple of different activities in it, including things like a data flow, which in ADF is known as a mapping data flow that runs on Spark Compute. I have a copy activity. I also have a for each in here. I don't have any activities in here yet, but you know, of course, I would eventually come in here, add an activity, and then I'll have a wait inside of my for each, which will iterate over those. Now, when I want to begin building these pipelines instead of an Azure Factory instead of Fabric, let me show you a way to really make it easy to get started. So, boom, here I am now inside of my Fabric workspace. And what you'll see is down here at the bottom left, you're going to have a selector where you can either switch to the Power BI experience or the Fabric experience. So I switched to Fabric, and I'm in my workspace. Now I can create separate workspaces for my different environments. But let's just stick with my workspace just for this demonstration. Now inside my workspace, I already have a series of items already created. I have Apache Airflows, I have pipelines, I have Dataflows Gen 2. I have a whole bunch of different types of artifacts or items within my workspace. There's a really simple and easy, very quick way to instantly bring in that Azure Data Factory I was showing you inside of my Fabric workspace. And that is by clicking on New Item and then clicking on Azure Data Factory. So you'll see it here in your list of different items that you can create. I'll go over to the filter box and I'll look for Data Factory. And it's right here. So when I click on this, it's going to prompt me to give. So I'm going to see all the different data factories that I have in Azure, and I've already mounted, we call this mounting, I've already brought in my data factory that I was using for the demonstration. And so you can bring in any of those Azure data factories that you have, and you can instantly make them available. When you do that, a few seconds later, you're going to have access directly to the Azure data factory inside of your Fabric workspace. Let me show you what that looks like. So I'll change my workspace view filter to say Azure data factory, and you see that it is right here. This is going to be an exact mounts a link to that data factory that I was showing you directly from my browser. Now, as I have access to all these pipelines and data sets and data flows that I have, they will run as is from Azure Data Factory, but I can invoke them and I can edit them and I can manage them right here inside of Fabric. And what this will do for you is this will give you a way to quickly get started and then begin building your new native project as a Fabric Data Factory project. And when I do that, you're going to see that the experience is very, very similar and is almost identical in the sense that you're going to have almost no learning curve to get started and begin building your data factory inside of Fabric. So if I click on New Item and go directly to a data pipeline, and I can call this my new Fabric pipeline, you'll see there's going to be no learning curve involved because the experience is going to be the same. So now you can start on your new projects building your pipelines here inside of Fabric instead of an Azure Data Factory. So I can do the same thing. I can select the different Python activities. I'll start with a copy data. And then just like in Azure Data Factory, I can have a for each. And I can continue and build the rest of my logic here inside of Fabric.
That's a fantastic demo, Mark. It really brings a lot of these capabilities that we just talked about into action and perspective. Now, I'll get back to the question on, you know, how I started my journey with Microsoft is using Azure Data Factory.
Yeah.
So several years back, I was working for a healthcare customer, and they had the first version of Azure Data Factory, which was not super intuitive at the time. But then immediately, you guys were kind enough to, you know, do the Azure Data Factory version 2, which was a game changer for many of the, you know, workloads that I was trying to do from an ETL end-to-end data lifecycle perspective. Now, I know there are so many customers that still rely on Azure Data Factory as a standalone product. Now, what happens to those customers?
Yeah, I mean, so first of all, I mean, you're absolutely right that, you know, what we did with ADF and to make the V2 version of that for the code-free, which is what we're talking about now, that whole code-free environment to be able to build your pipelines that we brought into Fabric was built in Azure Data Factory first. And so we brought that forward because we understand that's really popular. Mm-hmm. And so as you start to work in Fabric, you realize that the learning curve is really low because you may have already built pipelines inside of ADF, and you can use the same skills, and the folks in your organization that have that skill can just transfer that into Fabric. So it makes it really simple. So your question about how do you then come into Fabric is a great one and a really important one. So one thing that I want to, you know, kind of start you with is what I have on the screen actually here is actually a QR code for a link to our primary set of docs that talk about this very topic, because it's more complex than we can talk about in a few minutes. And if I just start talking about this, you'll all lose interest anyway. There's a lot to read and learn about. What we do in this doc is we talk about how the similarities between what is there in ADF and what is there in Fabric Data Factory, and very, very similar, but different in a lot of really important ways that you'll want to read about. And really important that you'll keep in mind is that we've added some just exciting new innovations that come only into Fabric, things like the Copilot, so the AI enablement that I talked about earlier, the ability to send an email and a Teams message and to refresh a semantic model is really super simple in Fabric Data Factory. But you want to learn about those differences through that QR code. Now, the other thing I want to show you is that a great way to get started with building your Data Factory and Fabric is to take your existing Azure Data Factory and bring that in. What we call mount, but essentially is an Azure Data Factory item sitting in your workspace. So what you would do when you're inside of Fabric is really just click on the create new icon right here. And I'm going to actually just, I was going to cheat and search, but it's actually right there on my screen. If you click on Azure Data Factory, you'll see this as preview. I'm telling you, this is going to be generally available really, really soon. So Swathi, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take one of my existing Azure Data Factories, and I'm going to make that part of my workspace here in Fabric. So I'm going to go ahead and select this one here and click OK. And you'll see, like, within, you know, magic, within less than a minute, it becomes available to me in my workspace. And I just want to show you real quick, over in Azure Data Factory, this is what my factory looks like. And you'll also see, if you haven't seen Fabric before, that this is going to look very, very similar to what you see from a canvas in the UI, very similar to the same sort of thing that you see within Fabric as well, too, with the ability to build your pipelines and have your activities that connect and do all kinds of really interesting and important things. So all I did was I said, bring that into Fabric. And so there it is, it's inside of Fabric. Now, when I click on it, you can see that I now actually have that view into my Azure Data Factory here from my Fabric workspace, and everything that you saw over there is available to me here. There's all my data flows, all my data sets, all my pipelines, and there's that pipeline I clicked on in Azure Data Factory. And there it is inside of Fabric. So everything that was there is available to me inside of Fabric now by doing this. It's a great way to get started. If you're familiar with ADF, it's a great way to get started inside of Fabric Data Factory.
This is super powerful. I am super excited for all our customers who are already using Azure Data Factory. It's not going to be any different. It's the same seamless experience that you can have within, you know, Data Factory in Fabric.
Yeah.
So all you have to do is just do a few clicks, bring your existing Azure Data Factory instance into your Fabric workspace, and you can get started from there. So let me ask you a few pointed questions here. That piqued my interest a little bit there, Mark. So once I bring my existing Azure Data Factory instance, can you take me to the steps from a development perspective and also from a billing perspective?
Yeah, so from a development perspective, you're going to use your data factory inside of Fabric, the mounted Azure Data Factory inside of Fabric. You're going to work with exactly the same as you do within your Azure Data Factory natively. The nice thing about it is all within your workspace, so you don't have to, you know, change screens or windows or anything like that. It's all within the same thing. When that runs, it's going to run as an Azure resource, just like it does now, so nothing changes in that regard, but you can continue to add things to it and you can do that. The idea would be that now that you've seen your data factory inside of Fabric, now you can greenfield new pipelines natively inside of your workspace by building new ones. Use the QR code I had previously to walk you through, you know, the differences between the two. Start building your pipelines new there would be the goal that we would have for you. And one more thing, while we're at it, I want to actually show on the screen as well, is I have a QR code for the things that, there are some things within that Azure Data Factory native environment that aren't available to you exactly as it is inside of Fabric. And a great example of this is data flows. Data flows in Fabric with the Spark-based, what we call mapping data flows inside of Azure Data Factory are Power Query-based data flows inside of Fabric. And they're very, very powerful and they're very easy to use. But you have to get from there to the Power Query type. Now, what I want to show you is we have a couple of links on here that's going to help you to understand in a QR code, to help you understand how you can change those into native Power Query-based data flows, or with the QR code, go to a GitHub repo that actually gives an example of changing those mapping data flows into Python code that you can run from a notebook.
That is phenomenal.
Yeah, so if you want to run it as that Spark scale that map data flows do, you can run it as a Python notebook inside of Fabric. So use that. It gives you a good starter a kit on how to start doing that. So that should get you on your road to going from all the goodness you've built in Azure Data Factory over the years into getting started with these things in Fabric, yeah.
That is phenomenal. Really, when you think about it from a customer perspective, we're not really leaving anything behind. You're bringing all the goodness, like Mark said, into Fabric Data Factory. However, there's one caveat to it. So in Azure Data Factory, we have mapping data flows.
Yeah.
But in Fabric world, within Data Factory, you have data flows Gen 2.
Yeah.
But you are providing, you know, with the links, a seamless experience to port them, the same code that you have built in Azure Data Factory over to Fabric Data Factory.
Yeah. Yeah, perfect. For sure. Yeah, I mean, it's something I think that what we feel like that's just going to happen is you're going to get that, bring the Azure Data Factory item into your Fabric workspace. You're going to have that mounted there. You're going to start working with it. And then you're going to see just how much easier it is to use in Fabric with the AI Copilot capabilities. You're going to see the ability to run your data flow or to build your data flows, I should say, by using the Power Query interface, which is much simpler to use. You're also going to note that when you want to do things like send an email or refresh a semantic model, there's activities there that are only available to you in Fabric that just make that super simple and easy to do. And then you'll be off and running, building your pipelines now natively inside of Fabric from there. Yeah.
That is amazing. Before I wrap up this episode, I would love to get your thoughts on what is that one key takeaway that you want to leave for our customers and partners watching this episode today, Mark, on... Now, focusing on if I were to move from ADF to Fabric Data Factory, what is that one key takeaway?
So first of all, thank you for having me. This has been an absolute pleasure. And thank you all for watching this amazing podcast that's way this put together. But let me just say this, is that as you start working in Fabric, like you said earlier, data integration is part and parcel of what you do within Fabric, okay? If you have a lot of ADF existing IP that you've built, factories and pipelines that you've built out there, get started with what we showed today. So my key takeaway for you is that it's super simple to get started in Fabric. You're not relearning anything, right? We understand the power and the ease of use of Data Factory, so we've made it the same, essentially. It's the same, just better, right? Hopefully you saw with the Data Factory item, the Azure Data Factory item that we did, that mounting, that it makes it super easy to bring those in and then you're just off and running.
Perfect. Thank you so much again for your time today, Mark. Appreciate it. Thank you everyone for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget to hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you would like to see on the future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive into Microsoft Fabric.